Welcome, BotBuilders. This is Arin from BotPress, and today I'm going to be showing you how to build an AI-powered SMS chatbot. One that is smart, fast, and ready to support users directly on their phone. So if you're looking for an AI solution that can handle support or sales queries over SMS, this is the right video for you. We'll be keeping things simple. I'll walk you through building the bot and then wiring it up with Twilio to start handling real-world support requests. So let's head over to BotPress and start working on the chatbot. Alright, so first things first, you can go ahead and create a BotPress account or log into one if you are already in, and I'll quickly tell you what we are going to be doing today. So for today's example, I'm building a bot for a fictional roadside assistance service called AutoBuddy. The idea is simple, that remote customers can text in when they need help with their vehicle, and the bot guides them through the first steps before a human agent gets involved. So to start doing that, we can go ahead and create a bot. We can name it AutoBuddy for the namesake, and let's create it. Now, once the bot has been created, you can go ahead and open it in the studio. And first things first, instructions, knowledge bases, etc. So what we are going to be doing first is we are going to head over to this instructions tab. This is where you define the bot's personality and its role. It can be thought of as its job description. So take this chance to define what your expectations are for the bot. So I already have a prompt ready for it. So I'm just going to copy paste and tell you how. You can also write something that is able to work with your use case. The instructions can be very high level. You can write something like, you're a support assistant for AutoBuddy. Your job is to guide users, respond in concise SMS friendly tone, limit your replies to 25 to 30 words. I would ideally go for this if you are trying to deploy it on SMS, as we are trying to keep the conversation as quick and sharp as possible, and trying not to spend too much money on that. Once that is done, there is an instruction for it to strictly follow the knowledge base, not steer away from it and everything else. We're going to go ahead and save that. And once that is done, we are going to be adding a knowledge source to this chatbot. Now, the chatbot on its own is just working off LLM, mostly GPT or Gemini, whatever you're using. So to ground that LLM's knowledge to your own use case and your own company, you should upload a document which is true to fact and indicative of what services you are offering them. So for that, you can ideally upload a document which has all these information. Now, this document would look something like this. A document could ideally have a short FAQ about services, procedures like how to request towing or tire changes, service area details, emergency disclaimers, and everything in the middle. So my own document looks something like this, wherein we have a whole bunch of frequently asked questions like, what services are you offering and where you're offering it and such. So that's pretty much it for what we want to add to our chatbot in terms of knowledge. And with that, we are ready with the backend for our chatbot. And all we need to do is connect the chatbot to Twilio so that we can start communicating with it through SMS. All right, now that the backend for the bot is done, let us go ahead and connect it to our phone number so that the users can start interacting with it. Go to twilio.com, sign up or log in. And once you do it, you can head over to their console, which should bring you to a page something like this. You can go ahead and create a new account. Ignore the first account that I already have over here, as I'll show it to you later how it looks like. But I just want to quickly show you how you can set up this account on Twilio. To start off, you can write a name for the account. We are going to go for AutoBuddy, same as our chatbot. And what will be the account used for? So you can choose between Twilio and Flex. Flex, I believe, is their premium tier, which lets you manage a whole lot of other stuff around support and sales. But for our use case, we can just go ahead with Twilio, as you can choose to expand from there onwards. So account friendly name, what will be the account used for, and the billing country. So once we do it, you can go ahead and answer some of these questions Twilio has for you before you make your final account. I'll quickly do this and see you at the next step. So once you are inside the Twilio console account, it should look something like this. where it is asking you immediately whether you want to buy a phone number. Now, if you're on a trial account, you get a 10-digit US number. Pro tip, I've linked an article down below that breaks down what kind of number is best based on your use case, toll-free, short code, or long code. So go ahead and read it, as it may help you identify what kind of phone number you're looking for. Getting a phone number is pretty easy. In fact, you can bring in your own phone number. You can buy a phone number right over here, which works for you. And it's as simple as that. And with that, we have our phone number and all the information that we'll be needing for our BotPress integration and our bot to start communicating with this. We'll be using the account SID and the authorization token from here in BotPress. So let me just quickly take you back to BotPress and show you how you can add this information so that your bot starts communicating with it. So once we are in BotPress, you can head over to integrations and install Twilio on your workflow. Okay, we already have it here, so I'm gonna just select it and install the integration. Remember the two things that I told you in the previous step that we will be bringing in from Twilio, the account SID and the authorization token. Let me just quickly copy that. So once you are done with that, WordPress will generate a webhook URL. This is how Twilio will send incoming messages to your bot. And what we can do is simply just copy this and take it back to Twilio. Now that we have our webhook URL, we'll be going to the menu on left, choosing phone numbers, manage and active numbers. And that should take you to a list of phone numbers that we have currently on our account. What you can do is just click on the phone number that you wish to connect your chatbot to, head over down to messaging configurations, and in a HTTP post request, we're going to add our webhook URL over here and just simply save it. So once the configuration has been saved, all that is left is to publish the bot. And we can just do that simply by heading over to our WordPress studio and publish it. And now we are ready to talk to it. So let us go ahead and check it out. So let's get started with the testing. The first question I'm going to be asking the chatbot is, let us start with, hey. So it should ideally just start working right off the bat. Let me know how I can assist you with your vehicle today. And let's see. So thanks for letting me know. Are you in a safe location? Can you share the exact address or nearby landmarks? And I think you get what the point is. So now the chatbot will be able to use the knowledge that you have already uploaded and the instructions that you have given it to be able to help you with. So as you see, the chatbot is up and working, and that's pretty much it. I will quickly show you how you can track these conversations that are going on with users and what improvements can you make on this chatbot further to suit your use case. Okay, guys. So as I mentioned just right now, you can also monitor all incoming conversations right in WordPress. And to do that, what you can do is head over to the dashboard. And from here on out, just head over to the conversations. You can click individual conversations to see how exactly the entire exchange was. But right over here, we have a summary of the conversation being generated, which is able to give you an overall overview of what the conversation was about. So that's pretty much it. That's how you build and deploy an AI-powered SMS chatbot using Twilio and WordPress. It's fast to build, grounded in your own data, and flexible enough to scale. From here on out, you can start building on top of this foundation, add actions to schedule callbacks, connect it to a live agent handoff system, or guide users through multi-step troubleshooting workflows. For that, I would recommend checking out Matthew's advanced chatbot building video. Let me know in the comments what you are building, where you got stuck. I'd love to help. And until next time, happy bot building.